location of the... We're going to demonstrate that from now on. Okay, location of the... Okay, so... Now, ang concept so far pala ninyo for the standard definition is this. For muscles in general. A muscle will move a joint if it crosses. Okay, so that's an example lang. The tibialis anterior originates from the tibia and is inserted onto the medial piriform and the first incline. Okay, so, ayan. The origination from the tibia and is inserted in the medial piriform and the first incline. Will it move the medial? But, what will you do to the ankle joint? Will you torsi? Let's go. So, ang mundo mo yung pwede. Kung mag-hold ako sa action sa muscle, kung anong orientation niya. No? So, for instance, you have a joint here. Ang mga mo yung joint, no? Side view. Okay? Kung ang muscle, initially, so, ang axis yan, eh. So what will you do with this joint? Will you move this forward or will you move this forward with this muscle movement backward? So, example, the quadriceps femoris, which are very important part of it, composing your vasus lateralis, vasus medius, and vasus medialis, as your vasus femoris. Joints support your quadriceps tendon, wraps around the patella, from the patella tendon, is inserted into the tibial tumerus, will extend. On the other hand, these muscles here at the back, composed primarily of your hamstrings, for instance, is inserted partly at the tibia, some of it is inserted in the tibia head. So if this is extension here, what is the action of the muscles here? Okay? Questions? Wala. So, kung tatawad nyo ang pagtatawa ng muscle joint, tapos na nyo. Kung ang muscles are sa tubangan, extended. Kung ang muscles are sa tubo, okay? Kung ang iyang insertion is located medially, yun ang medially yung tibia. Kung iyang insertion are sa skin, wala. Okay, now, let's complicate the incident. Let's see it ako, you know already, that the, what is going on? Let's see it, when we put up, you know, the hamstrings, the hip joint, let's see it ako, ang hamstrings originates from the ischial tumerus. Correct? Leo? Ano yung ischial tumerus? So, kung hindi po yung arithmetic, that the hamstrings mo originate the way, that hindi siya masulod sa iyo ng pibina, ano yung action siya? So, lait siya yan. Kung sa hip siya, extensor siya, pero kung sa knee siya, flexor siya. Okay ba? Simple lang. Now, ayun, ang putot na kamo. Ang quadriceps ko di apat, tamasot. Your vasus lateralis, vasus medialis, vasus medialis, vasus femoris. On the four, four forms, of the four muscles of the quadriceps, all four is capable of extending the knee. Four forms. True. All four, quadriceps, quadriceps tendon, patella tendon, tibial tumerus, they all extend the knee. But only one is capable of flexing the hip. Yeah, only the rectus femoris, kina. Ang vastae mo, or your four vastae muscles, all originate from the shaft of the femur. So, wala sila action sa hip joint. Only the rectus femoris, which comes from the anterior iliac spine and the acetabular rib, would be capable of flexing the hip joint. Flexing the hip joint. Paya? Okay, sige. So, nakuha niyo na ba ng adductor muscles before? Dr. Longus, Dr. Belvis, Dr. Magnus, Dr. Basilis, and part of the interest of when you took up the, sorry, the junior university, but if you took up the adductors, true or false, all adductor muscles are capable of moving the hip joint. All adductor muscles are capable of moving the hip joint. True?
True.
Okay. But only one is capable of moving the hip joint. True. Only the receivers. Okay? So kung tanawin nyo, tanawin nyo lang. Pwede ako ninyo ng hip joint, no? Ang adductor nyo, para matapos na mo mag-memorize sa adductor muscles, ako yung pwede na pag-memorize nyo yung cruz, brevis, brasilis, matus. At ito ha, ito lang ha. Na muna ako mag-memorize, kaya hindi ko mag-memorize. So ako siya, kung matanaw ko mo, ang adapt, okay niya ko siya ng mga YouTuber ko. Ha? Ako ninyo yung YouTuber ko. Ako ninyo siya yung mga bodies and pubis. And then you have your superior pubic crown. Tapos, superior ramos at iskyong at iskyong. Ano nyo ba? Ang locus galing siya sa tuber cells sa bodies and pubis. Correct? Ang brevis naman niya, sa superior ramos at ang brasilis naman niya, superior ramos ang brasilis, sorry, inferior ramos ang pubis, at superior ramos ang sa iskyo. Tapos ang magos naman niya, superior ramos, inferior ramos ang pubis, superior ramos ang iskyo, at iskyo. Siguro, sa pasubog na. So kung tanawin niyo siya, kung ako ninyo yung pubis, simpisis pubis, ako ninyo yung pubic tumor cell, ako ninyo yung body sa pubis niyo, inferior ramos ang pubis, superior ramos ang iskyo, nagamit niyo ang iskyo at tuberosity. Ano lang siya, oh? Longus, brevis, gracilis, magus. Oh, ikapos ng moraiso. Tapos, linea aspera, medial surface of the tibia, linea aspera yung adductor tubercle. Common nerve supply, obturator. Anong actions ng adductor muscles? They are adductors of the hip joint. Tara, masakala nila, no? They actually adapt the hip, but they are also medial rotators. Sili nila, kung magkwa, ano ang kinesiology next year? Hanesem. The book in Shorzy will make mention that palibdina ang adductor. Conflex, kung yung mga hips are flex, extensor sila sa knee. Kung yung mga hip, knee is extended, flexor sila sa knee. Flexor sila sa hip. So, kalahin-lahin ang ilang na function depende sa axis nila. At sa yung so, may questions pa? So, imuun ko na lang sumunod para matapos.
Extend, no? Laban. Ikaw ito nag-text sa akin? Sino ito nag-text sa akin? Sa saan? Wala ko lang. Makapiguro iba. Okay, mas hindi pa yung kapo. Malakad ko daan. Malakad ko.
Okay. So, pag-bisip. So, mag-focusing yan. Ano, just really, ano ang muscle ang attach kayo? Tendon sa ano muscle na attached
to it?
Quadriceps. same time have quadriceps, you form the quadriceps tendon, wrap itself around the patella, then the tendon changes its name. The quadriceps tendon, you know, siya kapatella, like, it's the same. Then it's inserted sa medial tuberosity.
Let's take after last
religious religious opinions. So I'll tell her to raise her hip as high as possible. Okay? No, no, raise the hip of that person as high as possible. See, as high as possible. Okay, okay, okay. See, up, up, up. Now, if you notice, you'll notice that as she goes, as her hip goes upwards, ang yan ang body, inalignan ang buwan sa sun. Inalignan. Okay, so ang himota will be may hazel stress. Okay, it's a block na hip, nasaya siya. That's story lang. So, hindi okay. So, ang iyan ang buwan, ang iyan ang points of action is up to here. Okay, imagine nyo na lang to make a temporal note on how high it is. Okay? Now, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to make her lean towards her right side. Make her abdominal, and let's see how high it is abdominal. But not, in fact, if you ask her, she can feel a cramping sensation here at the hip area. Why? Because if she does this, her muscles are shortened. Tapos yung contracted ko din, nagmula ng muscles, so that reaches an Achilles tendon. So, lesson na natin sa physiology, yung maximum tension in the muscle is here of this note if the muscle is in a lengthened position. Correct? Okay? So I'll begin. Okay. Now, punisin ka rin po siya, punisin ka rin po siya na i-raise siya niya na pag-upang. Punisin ka rin po siya na i-raise siya niya na di. Okay? Extend, kung let's say, I tell her to extend the knee this way. Okay? And I resist it, they like the tattoo. Okay, tattoo this one, tattoo this one. Okay, now, so, I'm contracting it what you said. But if the weight is heavy, a tendency is made is to lean backwards, and some of you go to the gym. You notice that if the weight on your leg is very heavy, you lean backward. Why? Because if you do this, purely, mas tayo ng hindi siya ng movement. Ito yung rectus femoris. But since the rectus femoris is shortened, kay flex ng iyan na hindi. Ang tendency lang, maghihin na siya backward para maglaba ang rectus femoris na makagenerate kung siya yung lung tension to extend the knee. Ano lang ang mechanism ng isang lung tension relationship natin? Okay? So, for example, ako na siya ang reason sometimes na kung by articular ang muscle sa TJ. Actually, sa student, kasi sila is very chat na ako po sa US. Okay. Now, ang ilang insertion the deeper man. Tinga ha? Kung tatawon mo, ang semi-membranosus mo, ang semi-membranosus mo, are inserted near or at the medial of the tibial, it's like here, tibial superior surface. Yes. For the semi-membranosus, and the semi-membranosus is inserted here. Superior, superior part of the tibial. Okay? Whereas the biceps femoris is inserted at the tibial end. Okay? So, kung tatawon mo it, nabigyan ng mga hamstrings, may luwag na katulig, may luwag na katulig. Ang ilang action in this case is
Nag-shot din.
Okay? Pero, sulit siya sa limong mga quadriceps. Okay? So, dahil nila, ang ilang mga insertion, bigyan siya, bigyan niya, yung luwag na niya, bigyan niya. Okay? Now, ang ilan na nerve supply palaligo, kasi sa inyo, ligo ko ito dapat sa iya. Actually, mas namin kung maklasify hindi siya kung ang nerve na supply sa iya, sa iya, o hindi. At ito naman ako, kung tunanyo hindi ang nerve, ang sciatic nerve as a nerve, ang sciatic hindi yan. Wala na siya may ginasupply yan ng muscle. Ang sciatic is just a term that they use for the big trunk of nerve at the back. That is composed of two trunks, the peroneal and the tibial trunk. So, gusto ko mag-memorize lang ko sa nerve supply ng spirit of the muscles. Okay. So, kung mag-memorize ko sa spirit of the muscles, sila man yung kukon, tibial or peroneal branch siya sa okay? So, ilang ang nerve supply? Binitibial branch sa sciatic, binitibial branch sa sciatic, binitibial branch sa sciatic, binitibial branch sa sciatic. Okay? So, isa lang. Only the short head is supplied by the peroneal branch sa sciatic. All the three are supplied by the peroneal branch sa sciatic. Common peroneal. Common fibula. Itawag na siya ng common fibula, but we rarely use that. Kaya, ang peroneal, kundi sciatic na siya rin, sa likod. Pagbuhas ng sciatic, hindi sa may superficial fossa, kung sa divide na siya ng 2. Ang tibial that goes down further, and the fibula, or tibia, or peroneal, that goes around and circles the head of the fibula. Okay? And goes to supply the anterior root of the muscle. Okay. It further divides into your superficial and deeper which you can take up the abdomen and the foot. Okay? Anyway, so what are you going to learn to fly? Possibly bend, and up the leg, hip, and knee. Okay. Which one crosses the hip?
Semi-bend.
But all four causes problems. So kung takaw niyo sa triya, all four causes the knee, but only one causes the hip. Sa likod naman niya, all four causes the knee, but only one causes, does not cross the hip. Only the short head of the biceps. So, sa posterior group naman niya sa muscles, that goes the knee and ankle, you have the following muscles. Like your popliteus, your gastro, of which you have two heads, no? The medial and lateral head, and then your all the rest, ang iyong mga soleus, flexor digitor longus, flexor hallucis longus, don't cross the region. They are all movers of the ankle. Okay? So, ang iyong mga origins is a Confucius is lateral condyles of the femur, a medial and lateral gastro, depende kung lateral head ka sa lateral condyle ka origin, kung medial head ka sa medial condyle ka. Okay? Tapos, ang plantaris naman, originates sa lateral supra-familiar ridge of the fistis of the okay? Now, ang obliquus is inserted sa tibia. Digitalis. Sorry, ang tanong niya? So, practical na kapag ito para ito siya niya. No? So, additionally, sa lateral condyle, so, lateral condyle, inserted siya sa tibia. So, features ko siya. So, ano niya ang muscle? No? Injury, inserted sa tibias. Injury, inserted sa
gastro.
Which head?
Lateral.
Injury, inserted sa tibias.
Medial head.
Medial head sa gastro.
Yes,
need. Ang plantar is kuya, ang isuri of lateral supramandibular ridge, inserted mo siya sa pangkakilis. Ang plantar is actually, kung mag-dissect na ako, gagawin na ako ng muscle. Wala pang din na siya, actually, sa leverage here. Ang tendon is na kalabang-laba, and sometimes it is used as a donor or as a remote, like tendon of chicken, pinaharvest, at ito kung puro niya, ito kung hindi ko, maging tapik-tapik sa mga tendon na nilagod. So, it is used actually as a donor, tendon. Okay? So, maputol pa nga po. O, Ariel? So, ano po mo? Anong common insertion? Sige sa tatlo? Ano ka po?
C.
Tapos, K. Yeah. Okay? Nerve supply. Tibial trunk is lateral of the sciatic nerve. Tibial nerve is lateral. Okay? Tibial nerve is lateral. Okay, sige, makapunta ka mo, okay? Action on the hip. Action on the knee, and action on the ankle. Sa hip, action sila wala. Saka wala ang kid, no? Tinga, at least may kami, no? Tuhod, mas wala. Sa knee.
Flexors.
Ano?
Flexors.
Very good. Flexors, kaya sila sa likod, no? Flexors sila. So all of them are flexors on the knee. Okay, now, how about sa ankle? Sige, ready ko, plus minus. Ang pangkutus, delikalin, inserted din. May action sa knee, wala. Wala. Wala siya. Kaya yung tatlo niya, ano action nila sa knee? Sa atwal? Torsi flexion or plantar flexion?
Plantar.
Questions? Wala. Mapagpunta ka mga. Kung let's say the movement sa muscle, ayun, ang movement sa muscle, ang movement sa muscle, halimbawa, tagapakan ko yun. Kung gusto niya ang rotational movement sa muscle, ano niya ang movement? Medial o lateral rotation? Medial. Ang matanong niya, kung tutungo niya na, medial rotation. So, makatang ito ako, ano action sa Medial rotation. Lateral rotation. Sino po? Oo, naman may lateral rotation siguro. Sino pa sige na wala? actually you can pivot on your with a fixed goal like this. Kamu di si basketball, kalau kamu mau masuk ke Europe, kamu sana sih jangan turun, okay? And we can prove that. Si mana mana sebola, kita jangan turun, kita tu bang masih, kita tu. Karena kita improve tak pun kita itu dan dia nak dia. There is a screw home mechanism itong what the screw home mechanism mean? It means that as your knee goes into extension, it goes into lateral rotation like this. So though we need some carabon, nasira siya muna. So those who are standing up, quietly stand up. Then check if your quadriceps or your hamstrings are contracted. It's not contracted at all because God has made it such a way that your joints are so efficient that kung mag-screw home at siya muna ako, wala kasi masa yung na-contract, energy efficient. Kung you imagine kung na-contract at all the time, you will be exactly with your energy, pag-contract na siya to support your way of life. So, ayun, tanawang ta? Relax. Yang tiga cikros itu tadi malam. Ibu tadi datang ya tiga cikros. Kita Ada tiga cikros itu ya. Oke. Tunggu mau entah sebong. Kita extend tu yang tuhut. Extend. Oh, kami tak tiga cikros itu. Tiga cikros itu ya.
Isa ko na lang ako sa simbahan, dati broke naman ako, hindi ako sa
everything is heavy in God, right? So ang tendency pa yun, God will be put more forward. Correct? So ang yoga's to, kung si ba? Oh, kung si ba? So kung may mas women, wear 10-inch heels, for instance. Ang tendency nila, ginapa-heel nila kinakalawas forward. Okay, so pag heel sila, was nila forward, mas madugangan ko ang mga pulling forward. So at the end of the day, anong matago kung kahit sa mga actually sakit ng mga tingin? Kung isakit ang mga ba, kaya ang tendency nila ina-extend yung mga lawas to bring the center of gravity again upwards to the side of the upper position. So, ano ang purpose ng height here? Calculate height.
Posture.
Well, actually, it really accelerates the curvature of your spine.
Yes.
Yeah. For size C, you become size E. Kung kahit ito magayin, kung kahit sila, functional purpose ang hygiene except to do that. To attack the opposite experience. So kung ano makita ko mga hygiene sa tabakan niyo, kapagano mga mo ko na ang tuloy niyo.
Para wag namin peculiar walking para ma-attention.
Ang tendency to exaggerate the curvature and the outer biomechanics of your bone from a regular gait, a straightforward lap, it becomes now a swaying gait that moves from side to side. Oh, hindi
niyo mo siya
So, kapalo na mo, kung ano ang purpose nila. Now, tinatawag na sila nung anong nila to monitor for sa to is ano barbers
barbers
man wala na kami sinakaabot kay sa unang atsimpo sa ligat sa siya sa bagero may panik na dahil ginamahan na para ilagla sa babaha hindi ko lang na hindi na ako kaptuan last na yung pangusap yung shade sa prosok kung nasa razor pala sa kikit sa siya sa bagero may panik na dahil ginamahan na para ilagla sa babaha para mabait sa razor sa tutsura yan ito anyway so tanawa ni Ben alin siya din intervention din. So ano siya ang action niya sa hip flexor or extensor?
Flexor.
Flexor siya. Sa knee joint.
Extensor.
Okay, so isa lang hip ka muscle, isa lang hip ka muscle na supplied by your femoral nerve. Is a flexor.
Flexor.
Extensor.
Okay.
Sartorius, that's just it. Iria, it is an external rotator of the hip. For the knee joint, it is a medial rotator of the hip. Okay? External rotation siya sa hip, tapos medial rotation siya sa now, kapag tingnan mo sa term na best and serious term, kasi mga kapag tingnan.
Sa best.
Ang best and serious term,
best and
serious term. Pag best and serious term, tingin sa pato o tingin sa pero ang pesa siya na sabi is composed down of three letters, no? Your semitend, your disease, and your support. O anong po ang pinag-inigol nila sa action? Is it okay? They are all medial rotators. So pag sinipusin nyo sa isa, what is the common action of your best and serious tendon? Ang action niya is?
Best ano na dyan?
Basta ganyan. Pwede ko mag-ipat.
Ano?
Ang insertion is medial. It's medial rotator siya. Kung ang insertion niya lateral, lateral rotator siya. Tanawa nila, now that you have a good picture, a clear picture sa mind mo how things are organized, it's easier to memorize. Okay, so matutol na kami ulit. Ano ang muscle ang alin sa ischial tuberosity that is inserted in?
Sartorius.
Long head of the biceps. Okay? How about sa linya spirala, tadi?
Short head.
True or false? They have the same nerve supply.
False.
The long head is supplied by the tibial trunk of the head. Whereas the short head is supplied by the tibial trunk. True or false? Both are flexors of the knee. Both are lateral rotators of the knee. Okay? Oh, may nalimtan po mga muscle na daak sa knee o nabinilista. Tatlo. Obturator interns originates from the internal surface of the obturator membrane and is inserted into your greater trochanter. So you can see it across the edge. Okay. This muscle originates from the lateral surface of the ilium, the sacrum, the coccyx, and the subtrochanter.
So,
fatigue is muscle.
Yeah.
sinabi na nila, are you? Lateral surface ay yung mga ilyo, sacrum, coccyx, kalahuin mo nga sacro tuberous ligament, kaya siya ganin. Okay? What is the gluteus maximus? Bakit ito tsaka ko? Ang gluteus maximus extends the hip. Yes. Extends the hip. Okay, magkutot ka mo. The gluteus maximus is an extensor of the knee. Six, yes. 25% of the gluteus maximus is inserted into the gluteal tubercle. But 75% of the gluteus maximus joins the fibers of your tensor fascia lata to form the radial tibial tract. The radial tibial tract is inserted into the lateral condylar of the tibia, and both muscles are used to extend the knee. Okay? Kung mag-squats ka mo, masakit yung knee. Kasi yung knee, mag-squats ka mo because the gastrocnemius, by virtue of its action here, post-change siya, it is capable of extending the knee.
Okay? Pero sa hip, extensor man siya. I'm the trust.
Extensor, the hip. Iliac crest. And then is inserted together with your your gluteus maximus to form your iliotibial band. Okay. Visual where your iliotibial band is. Kung mag-practice na ako sa kanina, wala nang pagkakasiraya, di ba? So you will more be relying on your surface of the okay? Move back. Para na ang center gravity makakilis sa likod so that they can extend the hip. Ang ginausapan din nila to extend the hip is your ligament na. Iliofemoral ligament na. So ito kung hindi yan din, yung iliofemoral
ligament
na. For the hip joint. Okay, we have any questions? Okay, isa pa kung mga gulagi. Isa pa kung mga sir. It originates from the inferior ramus of the pubis and the superior ramus of the ischium. Inserted together with the sartorius and the sartorius on the superior medial surface of the tibia. You're a doctor.
Thank you.
By virtue of its the virtue of its insertion, ang action sa imo adapt ng proceedings of the region is the flexor, the day, region, the day. Okay? May question ka mo? Ma-bladder break na tayo.
Ironing and blue
facial muscles, ang maximus, inferior. Ang minimus ng medius, tensor pa sila ka, inferior muscles. Okay? Punta. Collectively, these muscles are called your hamstrings. Okay, pleurocores. The two muscles here, both cross, the hip, and this one.
Biceps.
Only the biceps long head crosses the hip joint. The biceps short head is a uniarticular single joint muscle. Kita ko yung ito tayo, one shape na space here. Ako na siya natawag ko ang pinsan ko sa. So, kung naman pag-ulta ka mo, ano ang boundaries ang pinsan ko sa laterally? Correct. The biceps, the morris of this side, security, and the lateral head of the gastro. Whereas, yung medial border naman niya is the SS, and the lateral, sorry, lateral, hyoid biceps, hyoid medial, okay, medial is semitend, semitend, and medial head of the gastro. A lateral here is short and long head of the biceps. Para ating mga lateral now, through our calls, the semi-membranosus and semi-tendinosus muscles are both flexors of the knee. The semi-tend and the semi-mem are lateral rotators. The iliotibial band, by virtue of its insertion, helps in the biceps femoris during lateral rotation. The iliotibial band, together with the biceps, are lateral rotators. Sinita, kung insertion, sorry, ano kayo ka ka ni Sorian to. Kung media na iyan ang insertion, media na iyan ang siya. Kung lateral na iyan ang insertion, lateral na dito. Okay? Questions? Wala? Okay. Ako ang muscle nyo, problema sa Diyos kung puso ka two heads of the gospel kingdom sa pastor soil is Carinia Antonius, which only originates from the Ibia Fibila in the Ethiopian stream, does not cause the leader. So it's a pure flagstaff, pure flagstaff soil of the Ibia. Wala siya yung action.
Along the straight axis of the tibia, you will have this angle here.
which is about 170 degrees. So, ako na siya yung new na Femorotibial angle. Now, yung new Femorotibial angle, which ranges between 160 to 170, kung ang imong angle is less, becomes less than 170. Ang matapusin mo sila, ma-focus sa ano-chino, parus na. Pero kung more than naman siya, ma-chino, parus. Okay? Do you have any questions? Now, ano yung angle of anti-version? How do you determine the angle of anti-version? Ako ang nila ba natin? Sa x-ray plates, kaya it's a functional angle actually with the transverse plane as a reference. Okay? Now, ang angle of anti-version nyo, pinausaran nyo lang natin, determine sometimes ang tendency nila sa patient to have an auto or an into. No? Kaya siya. Kaya yun. So, ano niya siya ang angle of? Hindi mo siya.
Perfect.
committed siya, tapos siya movements. Kaya nga, ang reason sinabi, kung ang inyong enjoy, unique siya lang siya, ang inyong movements na CJ. Actually, what renders your joint as having a fluid movement and flexibility in your core is because of the seemingly incongruence sa articulating surface. Hindi sila pala angular equivalent. So, kasi mo, kung 90 degrees ni, 90 degrees man ang yes in the angular value, hindi so, equal siya. So, yun yung toes. That's why na, maski ano pang abansi sa medicine, subo, hindi nila ma-duplicate ang original movement of the joint. Maybe because of the unique configuration of the movement. So, mamahin mo kaya, as humans, perfect, kinaya ang congruent na one na was this na alignment. Pero again, it does not follow the original. So, muna na, it does not last actually. After a while, mapatid siya kasi there will be undue stress in certain parts of the appliance. Kaya wala siya nasunod sa original configurations. So, for instance, my experience, yun ay kung hindi ka pa rin professionals. Kasi yung tipi ko sa kanya sa place sa PA. After a while, maybe a year after, may mga fatigue sa tali sa place. Kaya nga, ang alignment sa place, for example, hindi ka rin kung siya sa knee and profound protosis ng kakilaya. So may knee joint ka. Kung patawin niyo, kung i-plot niyo ang axis sa knee joint, i-plot niyo ang line from the medial and lateral contact, hindi na siya straight. Nag-tent na siya tapos lang. Pero kung magbuntang ka sa mga clients sa situhod, equal in a yet, hindi mo lang pwede nga isang kahit siya sa babaw, isang kahit siya sa dalo. So after a while, because ang alignment sa inyong mga clients, hindi pa rin yung mutual, ma-adjust na din, or else the patient can have discomfort, may mga undue pressures sa iyong mga client. So kapag-adjust mo na, kasi hindi na siya nakapagod niya, hindi synced it perfectly, ang movement sa knee, sa brace. After a while, ang brace continue na siya kapatid na metal o tub. Nalilis ka ba? Aside from overuse, ang mga appliance may namang usara na sa lawas, especially among disabled patients, maybe maximally can last only for about a year and a half, 2 years. Kaya na, because of that factor. Hindi tayo pa lang pitin na imperfections ng ating project. Okay? Awesome. Do you have any questions? Wala. So, we'll take it up the angle and then, so, ating next na power is the balance of life. Okay? So, kung tanawin nyo din, ang pattern sa blood supply sa puso, starts na na siya from the external media, no? External media, hindi siya. Pag-agi nga sa imo na imunitarian, can change that siya to femoral. Okay? Ang femoral, may branch na siya originally na profunda femoris or deep femoral. Paano na, no? Tapos sa deep femoral, may pinaka-branches. 6. You have your medial, femoral, and lateral femoral circumflex plus 4 perforating branches. How many sila mga perforating branches? Sir, kasi ba yung sila muscle substance? Okay? Sama na siya. So, medial, lateral circumflex, kanan, perforating, apat na yun. Ang terminal end sini, sa inyong profunda, deep femoral, contributes partly sa supply sa sa knee joint. Okay? Simple lang actually. Pag nabot sa knee, as it passes to the adductor hiatus, ang femoral, so it's an area, femoral niya, will change its name to hypopitchial. Okay? Hypopitchial contributes about 5 branches to the knee joint. Ano niya mga branches sa pupitsal ng knee joint? You have your sural, have your medial and lateral, superior and inferior genicular. When they operate on the knee, it's one of the most bloody procedures that they can do because of the rich blood supply around the knee. Yeah. No? So, ano siya? So, in one picture, sorry, bilang superior and inferior genicular. Wala siya. No? Medial, sorry, lateral genicular, lateral medial genicular, superior inferior, the same thing. Okay? As it goes down, ang popliteal mo will divide into two. Ano two branches ang popliteal distally? Anterior and posterior tibial. Tapos, from the posterior tibial, din ang gamit ng superior artery. So, sa leg na na siya, okay? So, kung ano ang what are the five major branches of the popliteal artery that supplies the knee? Hapus lang kita ang apat, geno, knee, genovalgus, genovalus, genicular, and siya. Okay? So, you have your superior, inferior, lateral, genicular, superior and inferior medial genicular. And of course the sural, which are really small branches. Okay? So true or false? The deep peroneal or profunda femoris, the distal end of the profunda femoris contributes also to the knee joint circulation. True. So, deep branch sa profunda femoris.
Kapag nila na sa memory system sa pabaw pala, diba? Ito ba yung gen natural complex, no?
Okay? Okay, questions?
Ang fibular, yung branch kanina? Fibular.
Fibular. Perineal, artery. Posterior tibia. Posterior tibia. Okay?
Kaya saan sa tunga, yaw?
Kung magpapunta ka mo, what are the tributaries? What are the tributaries of your popliteal vein at the knee? Sinihan niyo po? Para hindi kang makakonfuse pag-memorize kung isang artery at vein, ang lagi ko. Ang artery at vein, exactly the same as the branches. Galing kayo, except for the large arteries, no? There is one artery and two veins. Paano? So, ano yung tawag nila ng DNA concomitant veins? Or in English terms, concomitant veins. The name of the vein is the same as the artery. Galing kay, ang ilang ang flow, paliskan. Ang isa ay alit sa heart, makatuto sa punta. Ang isa naman ay alit sa punta, makatuto sa heart. So, masiling ka. Kung sa artery kaya, branches. Kung sa vein kaya, tributaries. So, sa kung nakakuha pa mo sa geography before, kasi mo sila na, ano ang tributaries sa suba A? Ang suba A has tributaries kind of from suba C, suba B, suba A. Maga? So, kung magpapunta ka mo, kung let's say may vein initial, kung vein initial, ano ang tributaries? Ano ang tributaries sa popliteal vein?
Medial, lateral.
Correct. Your medial, lateral, anterior, genicular, your posterior, inferior,
medial.
Tibia. Sa veins at sa artery.
Genicular.
May superficial veins. Kaya, nabalang mga dugat na makita ninyo sa sa kamot, nagdugan mo ako si Kali, di ba si Lay? Sa tigil, ano? Lesser and greater sa Pinos. So, greater sa Pinos niyo, sa common iliac siya yan, sa iliac siya yan, Lay, ang inyong lesser or small sa Pinos, sa imo siya yan ang pagkakitiyan. So, on top of this, pain na nila istoryanta, on top of these pains, nag-contribute sa inyong pagkakitiyan, may isa kapag-injaya ka lesser sa Pinos. Nag-school ko nila. Sila superficial ways. So, kung makita ka mo may divide, o lalaki ka may varicose sila, pains sa Pinos, okay? Ano na siya? Superficial or deep pain?
Superficial!
So, they can be branches of your lesser or greater sapinus. Ang lesser sapinus niyo comes from the medial, right? The lateral, and the greater sapinus niyo is from the medial. Okay? May questions, no? So, makututok mo. So, of course, the tributaries of the external iliac vein are so simple. Blood flows to the external iliac veins from the femoral vein. True or false?
True.
Okay. Now, the tributaries to the femoral vein at the hip joint are the profunda femoris. True. Sa hip joint mo, o sa kwan mo, sa inguinal area mo, ang gadrain na major vessel sa imong femoral, is your profunda femoris class. Okay? So, ang imong pagpitsyar, kung hinius man siya sa imong femoral. Okay? Sunod-sunod lang. Sa artery, ang flow sa blood, paamos yun eh. Sa vein, ang flow sa blood, so, kung memorize nyo ang artery, ang veins, the same match, kung masawa nyo yung libro, kasi yun na siya, the femoral vein, a similar vena cavitae test as your arterial system. So, kung memorize nyo ang vein, ayun na siya. Okay? Questions? Wala?
Saan ang hihila ng example? Yan, at hihila ng
example. Split naman ang mga example. Space, and then the is sure, for instance, if I was joined, and you're interpreting the disk, which is a part of that, and it's joined. Those are totally different types of things. Okay? So, ang piling ko kasi kung yung joined, ito ko yung pulling socket, pitch, regular, getting saddle, and the like. So, you have three articulating surfaces. You have your media, your lateral cruciferous joint, and your patellofemoral joint. This is your lateral tibio femoral joint, this is your medial tibio femoral joint, and on the side is your patello femoral joint. Okay? You will notice that, as I told you before, the fibula does not really take an active role in the knee joint. But you know, you will see later on when you take the ankle. You have the ankle part, this right, the tibia and the fibula. And below that you have the talus. When you move your ankle towards the flexion, the talus, the tibia and fibula abducts or separates from each other. The joint between the tibia and fibula is the distal tibia and fibula is a synovial, femoral is a fibrous joint. It is joined by an interosseous joint. So, wala na siya sa COVID-19. So, kung makuha ng teacher, the proximal tibio-fibular joint is synovial plane, but distal meaning is fibrous. Pero, both joints are integral to each other. As I told you, if you touch the fibular end of the side and you move your ankle like this, the tibio-fibular joint moves as well. Okay? So, okay. So, it's only siya relatively. Ang muna siya inter-osseous space. In an intact human being, this is covered by an interosseous membrane. Okay, next slide. We can talk a little bit. This is a picture of the picture. Can you identify other parts here? So, Anisha, which are a part? Lateral femoral condyle. And then,
Dr. Lee,
when you reconstruct things because of the mentor, kissing, it has to be here. Okay, next slide. So, let us just classify these joints. Now you have your patellofemoral joint, which is a modified crane joint. Movement there is gliding. Okay? We mentioned already last week what the function of the patella is.
So, what are the functions of the patella?
Shoulder dislocation, you know, relocate the shoulder. Because it is very tiring to walk in an extended
distance.
Okay? Sige. Next slide. Sustains vertical forces 4 to 6 times of the body. Anong bearing si Nate? Heavier you are, heavier the weight that the result gets. So, ang ginagawa ko ng present shape ay nagawa ko ng release na kawa ko sa mga sasakyan. Nasa kaya sa tuhod mo, ano mo na nga gawa ko sa shape ay sa'yo yung gusto eh. Because for every pound that you give your foot, the ground gives back to what it is saying. So, if your body gives or renders 4 to 6 times force on your knee, for every 5 pounds that you lose, you take off 20 pounds, 20 pounds of sitting on the floor. Oh! So kung masakit mo yung tuhod, masakit mo yung tuhod, tampok ka, umis ka, malus ka weight, pati-weigh mo yung mga tuhod, natinas. Kailangan mo patuloy, kailangan mo pakumbako mo sa atin. The river bank does not get loaded overnight, but because of the current flow of water through the years, it gets loaded. The same thing with your knee. So, similar, whatever indiscretion or foolishness that you do as a young person, you catch up to me. Okay, man? Yeah. For instance, at home, as we can get a good example of home, I play tennis. Play tennis since I was young. Right now, I'm eating tennis. Okay? So, but that shouldn't stop you. Okay? If there's anything that I should emphasize also, okay, is if your patient enjoys exercise, let them do it. But you can modify it. Okay? Because you gain more with exercise than not exercising. And that acts, you know, whatever. Don't exercise. Mobility is provided by bone articulation and stability, as we have mentioned, is rendered by cartilages, ligaments, and then muscles. Next slide. So these are self-explanatory. So palpable joint structures, okay, that. So here it is, you palpate nyo, and this, ang condyles ko lang yung femur, yung ating palpable. Okay? At if the condyle, ang condyle, ayaw ha? If the condyle is okay, correct. Okay? Now, ang tibiofemoral line, kapuna yung makapalpate. Ang sumang skinis ang tuhod nyo, palpate nyo na yung tibiofemoral line, then you go down. Ito yung question ng mga makakalap nyo na, then, of course, the okay, now. to take up the relevance of the ligaments in the what? Slide. So, palpable soft tissue structures. You have your open artery. Now, sa rehabilitation, we also deal with conditions involving the blood vessels. So, ang open artery is a relevant structure sometimes in cases of patients who have vascular disease. Kapag ito sinasang stories about individuals who have diabetes or being amputated. Ang reason sila nga na-amputate na sila is because of blood supply is sila ng is no longer adequate. So, ang binay mo na ito, in our field, ang kung kasi yung chetis na sa history of diabetes or hypertension, ina-palpate na ito na kaya ang number one risk for arterial disease is diabetes and hypertension. Pneumonia na, palpate niya ito sa diabetes. Kaya tapos yung medial artery here, sa behind the medial valvulus. Kaya kung yun ang mapatsagar, ang taso hindi mo mapalpate, is ang kumitya. And next to that, is the femoral artery. Okay? So, kinanglan, kina-assess yung transition. So, those are the palpable structures. And then, the semi-tentinosus system, you know, shows here.
Yes.
So, so, kung ano ni siya ang tendon niyo na nakakapan ko din? Yeah. Okay. The semi-tendinosus tendon siya. And on this side? Ang biceps. Okay. Ako na siya. Then, medial and lateral head of the gastroc, although you cannot palpate the medial and lateral head of the gastroc at the insertion, you can actually palpate it on this side here. Okay? Great. Kaya nga ah, ang imo nga biceps, laterally, ang semi-tent, semi-memo, medially, ang imo naman nga head sa gastro, araw sa dalawang gasuhon, so hindi mo siya mapalpate hindi at itself. Okay? Then your iliotibial tract, sa hindi ka. Okay. Pari siya ang iliotibial tract mo. No? Dili, on this side here. Okay? And then the peroneal nerve, actually ang peroneal nerve, mapalpate mo siya sa may fibular head. Dili o, the pet. Paglagandaga, ano nyo lang da? Actually, kung ipalpate ko na, hindi may mapatsagan kang atong ilo. Actually, it's the nerve that I am palpating. Ito pareho mabilas ang funny bone nyo di sa ulnar, dili on the side. Dili, amo na siya di ang ilong peroneal. Okay? Next slide. So, non-palpable structures will be obviously the articular surfaces of the femur, the patellar surfaces, the patellar fossa, medial lateral patellar line, upon the model. Ang medial lateral patellar lines, kung tanawon nyo ang linea aspera, bala suliun ta, double letter Y siya. Ang linya aspera niya, double letter Y. Amo na siya inyong medial and lateral supracondylar lines, ang pinaka-Y sa imong linya aspera. Okay? Okay, then you have your articular surface in the video, you cannot palpate that. Next slide. Sorry siya. No? You have your cruciate ligaments, then you have your lateral, then your medial meniscus. Amo ni siyang cartilage plate na silinan. naipagin na siya sa meniscus. No? Okay? Next slide. Intercondylar eminence, lateral, medial meniscus, cruciate ligaments, and then the transverse ligament. We will take this individually. Ang transverse ligament, kundi may ara ka mo medial and lateral meniscus, ang transverse ligament, ang muna siyang ligament, nag-connect sa medial and lateral meniscus. Ang cruciate, we'll take that up later on. Itawag siya ang cruciate, kito, across, no? Sige, next slide. Okay, now, yes. No. Ang meniscus is a cartilage. It's a cartilage. Siling ko ang ligament, nag-connect sa duha ka meniscus is the transverse ligament. We will take that up later on. Actually, may difference na ang medial at lateral meniscus. Okay. Now, flexion is between 120 to 150 degrees. Okay, so mamakot ko sa inyo. Hindi magawa niyo sa exam. For regular sitting, how many degrees do you need? Oh, nakamukha mo geometry, obvious na 90. How about for 90, kitiyan mo na? L. Okay, how about for climbing stairs? 30 degrees lang kinanglan nyo. Unless nga ang stairs nyo, muli ang taas. Yun na yan, 90 ka na. Depende ka sa height. Okay? So, pero kung ang regular na stairs, pero ito mamalang 9 inch na mo ang regular na height sa stairs. So, 30 degrees yan, no? Para makasaka, no? Okay?
Sorry.
Flexion is largely dependent on the muscle mass posteriorly. Obvious, no? Kung may bodybuilder ka, tungod na katakot-takot sa iyang hamstrings, hindi ka niya malabot kung muna na chifty. Kapag nasip yung iyang calf muscles, tako man, hindi na mawala ang labot ng 150. So, experimental siya. Ikaw. Apa. Flexion sa knee is maximum if the hip is extended.
True or
false? So, give me the blanks. Ano? No. Ayo, ito ang sinyo ha? Dahil lang ha? I-extend ko yan ang hip ha? Mariya, tanong nyo ha? Okay, flex. Okay? Medyo uncomfortable dito ha. I will extend her hip. And I will try to flex the knee. Flex the knee, flex the knee. It will not be as high. Why? Hugot na yung rectus femoris. Hindi extend nyo. Pero, sulit. Kung i-flex ko gani ang iyang hip, kaya rectus femoris, hello, mas ma-flex mo pag-iit ang iyan ang tulog. Open sense. Tinga, kung pahapaon ko siya, extend ko iyan ang hip, kasi ma-flex mo iyan ang knee, makugot mo siya, hindi kung hindi yan matigo fully. Okay? Do you understand? Okay, question. Extension of the knee is maximum if the hip is extended.
Good.
Diba, ha?
True.
If the hip is... So, nung tungo nyo lang itwende, para hindi ka mo malipat, ang ballerina lang. Ang ballerina lang ang katito. Kung ang ballerina ang katito, extend ang hip, extend ang knee, the plantar flex ang foot, amuna siya. So, everything opposite that also is true. So, extension of the knee is best if the hip is also extended. Why? Ariho, if the hip is extended, ay dito daw, dali ko, dali ko. Dito. If the hip is extended, this is shortened, correct? So, she can generate more tension on the quadriceps to extend the knee. Panya? But if the hip is flexed, Ariho, she will have difficulty in extending the knee, kay mahugot di siya dayo. Kay nga, hugot ang iyang na hamstrings. Do you understand? Oh, so sige. Maximum flexion, maximum flexion of the knee, hip is, maximum extension of the knee, hip is, hyperextension does not exceed 15. Galit na inyong lao, kita ka sa mga tao. Wala ba mga sa ako na so, kung kasayin di yung tao, sometimes doing this. Kung pag-imo ka ni ka pa SLR, relax na, if if dorsiflex may mo foot like this. Na amo ni siyang ideal din na flexibility. Now, pati. Kapalit mo nga may bearing, hindi siya sa inyong alipod. Now, sometimes, inflexibility of the hamstrings will cause back pain. Why? You know fully well where this is attached, correct? Ischial tuberosity. And the ischial tuberosity is part of the innominate bone which is attached to the sacrum, correct?
Yes.
It's just one chain. And the sacrum is already part of your vertebra. So any hamstring tightness can also affect your back. Okay, so ako nang nag-umpisa, kung may pasyente kami na may back pain, we also assess the hamstrings. Now, just on a clinical side, this test is called your SLR, straight leg raises. It should be positive for nerve impingement of the back between about 30 degrees. No, hindi na siya magawa sa exam. Sa MS, kung siya yung magawa. Maski medical, surgical, etc. So, 30 degrees na siya, no? Now, kung ang pasyente may sciatica, tawag nila impingement sa growth sa sciatic nerve sa likod, kung sa kaon mo nang tiyan ho, pag inabuto mong sciatic nerve, maipin na siya sa foramina and it will cause pain. Ang muna siya kinatawag natin na SLR or straight leg raising. No? So ang flexibility sa iyong hamstrings is largely dependent. Sa knee extension mo is largely dependent of the hamstrings, the ligaments of the joint. Now, pero, can you work on flexibility? Can you work on flexibility?
Yes.
Okay, can you work on flexibility? Yes, you can actually. Because your ligaments are elastic. Pero there is one component of flexibility that we cannot alter, and that is genes. May mga tao na media who are not as flexible as others. So, okay? And feel this from the right side. Okay, so motions of the knee, nakuha ka na knee, hips joint, sagittal plane, flexion, extension, then you have your medial and lateral rotation. Now, sa ang medial and lateral rotation na ito, i-observe din na siya sa flexion and extension. Pero, in certain sports where you need to pivot, you also require that. Now, kung nasigil, mas kwan ka wala. Tapos, nasigil gardening ka. Tapos, hindi ka gusto mong tingko. The top walk ka. You also need rotational movements of the knee. Nablang ka, kakita, kaya ka dala ka, shifting from our face here. Okay, you need those rotations. Next slide. Okay. Axial rotation is about 40 degrees. Para sa isang ha? Okay. Usually, rotates on the transverse plane and the knee's legs. Imagine nyo lang na may lateral and medial collateral ligament ko din. Ang inyong medial and lateral collateral ligament, kahugot na siya kung extended ang inyong tuhod. So, mamapag-usin nyo. Rotation is highest if the knee is flexed or extended.
Yes.
Very good. Okay? Una nga, basketball, lumpat ka. When you land on your foot, you land with the tip of your foot first, correct?
Yes.
Amo na nga ang tipalo, verne, highest. Kaya nga, pag land mo nga, plantar flex ang foot, ang talos mo nga narrow part yan, presents itself. So, ang imong joint mobility increases. May tendency nga nga mga tipalo. Wala na yan sa ankle, wala na sa foot. Pero, pag tupa mo, you don't land with a rigid knee, correct? You run with the flexed knee, and then you extend it again, correct? Kay kinalagas kasi mo kontra from the side. Pag-jump mo na, nagliso ka to avoid nga kwa agaw ni si Mumbuda nabili ni mo tiin so hindi easy kina ang mobility sa journal o is increase e pag flex siya mo na o slack ang ligaments tungkol si lingon ng rotational movements isa e pag pivot mo muna nag-uumot ang mga rubber shoes sa floor sa sulod o okay, kundi crochet ligament yung tuloy tayo. Now, there is more of external rotation. Obviously, kahit yung mukit pa ng mission movement, that media rotation. Okay? External rotation is twice as higher than media rotation. Rotation range decreases as the knee approximates full extension. Kumanta naman na. As the collateral ligament tightens, the rotational movement diminishes. Okay? Slide. Flexion extension axis. Okay, now, kung tanawon nyo, ang aton na knee is not a pure hinge joint, right? So, kung ang yes niya movement, actually, exaggerate ko lang dito. Tibiyan siya velocity na siya. Okay? Ang bakatabo, magsukot siya din ka roll. Pero as it reaches the end, good life. So it's not pure hinge joint. Ang iyong mga femur, ka-roll siya sa sukot, gusto ulit na lang, nag-glide na lang siya tapos na. So ang iyang axis na kung actually, kung yung plan mo, ma-axis siya, arindili, sa extension, pag sa may flexion, arindili. Gabong ang iyang axis, ang muna ginatawag mo, so, ako na siyang kumbay ang axis ng ligament. That's just for your information. So, pag silikang kami axis, ako na siyang fixed point where the bodies are rotating around, correct? No? So, pero since ang ibong joint, yung hindi siya pure hinge joint, ang iyang axis ng ibong along its position. That is called your equilibrium. Okay? Rotational axis is from the medial to lateral condyle of the tibia. Okay, so yung axis naman is from the medial to the lateral condyle of the tibia. More towards the lateral, so that's why the movement is more lateral. That's right. Now, kapag na nit, terminal rotations to home, free chain, at siligtan ako free chain, the tibia rotates laterally on the femur. When you are seated, the femur rotates medially on the okay? It is locked, meaning ano ang gan-lock sa screw bone po, mechanism, ang posterior cruciate ligament. Pero ang gan-lock naman, ako po open sa iya, kung pictures kiti. Tinabata na sa inyo, no? During extension, lateral rotation siya. Kung ipakontract niyo kung pictures, medial rotate ko lang kung pictures, correct? We generally rotate sa computers, pinabihan niya sa computers. Okay? Multiple choice niya siya mabasa. Exam. This muscle is responsible for unlocking the screw home mechanism. Thank you.
Question. So, ang pulse chain, ang pulse chain.
Yeah. Kung ma-reverse na lang, kailagin na, nakuha niyo niya sa first chapter sa anatomy. Ang definition sa origin is the fixed part of the fixed attachment of the muscle, correct? At insertion is the mobile attachment of the muscle, correct? Okay, now, but depending on your position, pwede na siyang ma-reverse. So, makukusin niyo. Can the hamstrings be used as extensors of the knee? Yes, close chain. So, kung naman ako mag-exercise ka, mas squats, wala? Hindi lang quadriceps mo madako, pati hamstrings mo madako, because you need more to extend the knee, the hamstrings also contracts. Masilingan doon, nilagay na. Nga, nagsilingan ako ng gym instructor, ako mag-bench press ko, madako nga ako ng pectorals. Hindi ko mag-bench press ko, extension na lang ang flexion sa elbow. Hindi dapat ang biceps ko lang ang biceps ko lang ang tako. Hindi natin glute ko yung mga tao. sense ko lang, sorry, galing ko ako, kasi natigloy ko lang may pababaw. Galing kayo, ang problema ay dito. Kaya. Okay. Ang pectoralis muscle niya, inserted dire sa lateral lateral lips ng imong bicipital groove, correct? Ang pectoralis major muscle. Okay? Now, kung tanawon mo pectoralis muscle, adductor, no? Flexor, and maybe medial rotator of the shoulder lang yun. Okay? Now, pero kung i-close ko ang chain by making her by making her use a bar with weights. Close chain siya. Kinagbugat na mo. So, himo niya, push up. Kung mag-push up siya sa weight pababaw, makontract niya nga pectoralis. Kaya nga, ang himo sa pectoralis niya, i-contract yang iyang belly para ma-flex niya ang elbow, correct? Pero since the arm is fixed to the weight, it is also capable of extending the elbow. Tignan niyo ko? Ang pectoralis will flex the shoulder. But if you have a fixed structure here on top and you allow her to sige, push up, mababatsagan mo man ang chest mo gatiga. Correct? Because what will happen is the pectoralis will pull on the humerus to extend the elbow. Okay? So kung magkotonto ka mo, is the pectoralis major capable of extending the elbow? Yes, it is capable of extending the elbow, open or closed chain? Usapan nyo na later on sa mga patients na may mga spinal cord injury para bala makasbot sila. Maka-shift pala sila sa bed nila. Kasi sa doc, wala pa niya strength. Sige nga, biceps and triceps na pwede ma-extend rin niya ng elbow out. Pectoralis. Okay? Okay. So, next slide. Ayun na. Ang bata to, has to loading and guiding components. No? Here, the incongruity of the articulated surface. The femoral surface is sometimes more than the tibial in size. Ang movement mo is not pure rolling or pure gliding. Kita na unyo bala sa side view, ang femur tama at katakot-tako, mas laba siya compared sa tibia. So, during the first phase, the roll siya, but during the lateral phase, lateral part, glide na lang na siya. Okay, so initial phase is rolling, terminal phase is like next slide. Okay, ayun na to, kukasyutin mo, kinakulukasyon ko na, what does the patella do? Hindi, alam mo, increases the leverage of the patella, provide bony protection, kinakseryeto ang patella. Okay, and prevent damaging compressive forces on the tendon. Balikin na absorb yan ang stress ng ginarender sa tendon, ang ginarender sa quadriceps during walking. Right? Okay. Now, ini-important kayo ito. Kaya kung ma-memorize nyo eh, nagpapalaan nyo eh, tapos na lang mag-i-chindi sa muscle center. There, now. Anteriorly located muscles are? Very good. Posteriorly? Medially inserted are?
Medially inserted.
And laterally inserted are? Example. Quadriceps. Extensor. Hamstrings. Extensor. Popliteus. From lateral to medial. From medial to lateral. Lateral rotator. Okay? Sorry. Lateral rotator. Medial rotator. Gali? From lateral to medial, so medial rotator siya. Ang imo naman nga biceps femoris is lateral, so it's lateral rotator. Okay? Amo mo lang iyang association, right? flexors can become extensors with performing closed chain movements. Napakalaki na, no? So, nakita ko sa patients na may polio. Kung may polio, sila receiving polio na quadriceps memories. No? So, maglakad sila, kita na ko sa patients na mo naman na. Okay? Wala na sila quadriceps, pati ko sa pag-extend nila ulit using the hamstrings na reverse nila original insertion, pwede sa hamstrings na extend na. Okay? By articular muscles, action of the knee joint changes depending on the position of the proximal and distal joint muscles.
Ano nga yung pasok?
No? So, ang leg tension relationship is important in active exhibition. So, kung nasilita na kung i-flex mo ang hip, mas ma-flex mo ang hip. Kung i-extend mo ang hip, mas ma-extend mo ang hip. Leg tension relationship. Okay? That's right. Now, rules. The quadriceps rule has only one by articular, that is the rectus humerus. Pero, kung tanawin mo, flexor siya sa hip, extensor siya sa hip. Okay? Tanawin mo na silinta, ako, kasi ang kapugat sa joint na sa weight na dinadala yan, bula yan sila mag, mag-extend sa knee, kung hindi sila mag-lean. E kung mag-lean sila, kalaba, rectus femoris, mas mag-extend nila yung buo. Okay? Arig lang na silinta. Make her extend the knee. You'll notice that she cannot extend the knee maximally. Correct? Why? Because all her muscles are shortened away. But if I make her lean backwards when the muscle is lengthened, she can maximally extend the knee. Okay? Ang mura na kumagat, kapag sa gym, pag may mga tao leg extension exercises, a proper tibial is 90 degrees ka ng tibial na ikaw para nga madala mo. Kung galing backward ka para madala mo ang weight, kung sino mong sila, ay hindi naman madala ang weight with the normal action na quadriceps. Okay? Sige. Suli naman yung hamstrings. Ang hamstrings, apat na sila, short, long head of the biceps, and the hands and the head. Isa lang iyan ang uniarticular, ang shortened lang sa biceps. All the rest are bilateral. So, sulit. Ang quadriceps siya, tatlo ang uniarticular, dua, isa lang ang biarticular. Okay? Of the adductor group, only one is biarticular. And that is your adductor disease. Okay? It's a flexor and medial rotator. None of the muscles contained in the rear compartment of the knee or of the leg crosses the knee. So, if you're familiar with the tibialis anterior, extensor hallucis longus, extensor digitorum longus, peroneus longus brevis, and peroneus tertius, none of them will have any action on the knee. Kaya nga, wala sila ga-cross the knee. Ang action na nila sa ankle ba na. Okay? So, talan ng muscles contained dito, wala gig sa action sa knee at all. All their actions are on the foot and ankle. Okay? Sige. Slide. None of the muscles in the lateral. On the left side. Three muscles in the posterior compartment of the leg has its action on the knee, which are flexion, of course. You have the two heads of your gastrocnemius, your plantaris, and your give me a moment to talk about. The soleus, which is part of the tricep surae with the gastrocnemius, originates from both the tibia and fibula and is inserted onto the calcaneus via the tendo Achilles or the Achilles tendon. Thus, it flexes the knee. No, that's not the result. There is a halim inserted. So, it is a plantar flexion of the foot, but it Itaas mo action ng bahina. Okay? The sartorius is the only muscle supplied by the femoral that is a flexor of the knee. Okay? No? Tarawasin lang. Originates siya from the anterior superior spine inserted onto the superior lateral surface of the tibia together with the facilis and the semitendinosus. Okay? So, ang reaction is flexion of the hip and flexion of the knee. Okay? The short end of the biceps is the only muscle innervated by the peroneal trunk of the sciatic. All the rest are supplied by the tibial. Okay, so true or false? All the pelvis of the quadriceps is supplied by the femoral nerve. True. All the four pelvis of the hamstrings is supplied by the tibial trunk of the sciatic nerve.
False.
Only one is supplied by the peroneal nerve, that is the short end. Okay? 75% of the gluteus maximus joins the fibers of the tensor fascia lata to form the iliotibial tract. Only 25% is inserted onto the gluteal tuberosity of the tibia. Okay? Slide. The pes anserinus is composed of the tendons of three muscles. We mentioned that already. And all three are flexors and medial rotators, okay, of the articularis genu, or otherwise known as the subcurius, is part of the belly of your vastus medialis. It's inserted into, inserted into the superior bone of the patella. It's responsible for pulling the joint capsule during knee extensions. Okay, next slide. This is the sartorius, femoris. Underneath that is the vastus medialis, vastus lateralis, vastus medialis. So, ang sartorius, nagkikwa ang vastus femoris, then you have the vastus medialis. These are your adapters. Next slide. Again, gluteus maximus together with the tensor fascia lata forms the iliotibial band. Okay. When you go into your clinics later on, you will notice that a lot of runners will have problems with the iliotibial band if they do ascent runs or ascent climbing. Because you need the gluteus maximus in extending the knee. So kung pataas ka na, ilalaga, by the end of the day, kung it's not flexible nila, they get pain somewhere here. So you get into a panic. Okay? This is the sartorius, the most of the sartorius, which you mentioned. This here is the pes anserinus slide. Lateral view. This is the biceps, the femoris tendon. This is the iliotibial band. Just the relationship. Quadriceps tendon, patella, and then you have your patella tendon. Okay, slide. From the back, gluteus maximus, your biceps, femoris, and your semitendinosus. Pabalaan yung man ang semitendinosus, see? Araw. May tendon siya. Ang semimembranosus naman niya may membrane. Okay? So, kapalo siya inyong mapupitchal po sa that's where your blood vessels are. Next slide. So deeper structures just illustrate to you the trunk of the muscles contained in the anterior compartment of the leg. We have many action on the knee joint. Okay? So these are the muscles in the anterior compartment. Next slide. Posteriorly, on the other hand, you have three muscles. You have your two heads of the gastrocnemius and the obliquus. The plantaris, that's in here, it's a very small muscle. Next slide. Okay, angles of the knee, what I mentioned before, the tibiofemoral angle, they said, is is between 175 to 170 degrees. We mentioned that if there's an end saturation of your iliofemoral angle, then you have your chino varus. Then if you have a diminution of the size of the angle, then you have your chino varus. Chino varus, if there is this increase of diminution. Not me. Not me as Gino. I'm Gino Valgos, pamano. Not me. I'm Gino Valgos, pamano. So, kung ang imo, may normal, ang imo ang normal, tibiofemoral, 117 siya. Ang imo niyo, 117 siya. Okay? Okay, so kung mag, ano na siya, kung mag-increase na siya, then, mag-diminish siya ulit, then you have your valgus, and then if it diminishes, then you have your valgus. Okay, slide. So, yun siya, sorry. Sorry, valgus. Valgus. Actually, sa gagmay ka mo, valgus, actually, yan. Kaya nga, sa sulod sa tiyan sa nanay, itanawin yung tanay na babies na chumaka sila. Sa sulod sa tiyan sa nanay, yung kuwan sa mong yung tiyan sitting pala, no? So that gives that attitude. As you grow up, it develops. Kung tangan ka tight, things and diet. For now, may ang mga ano wala ang mga 70-year-old Japanese individuals now largely tila ginagaan sila ng sakaw or paka sila because sa Japan ang mga Japanese natives sila na kinakamon ang ilang bata nila sa ibig nila. So remember that the whatever stress you put on your joint will influence the attitude of the bone. So since pere sila ko sa rice fields, gaaba sila sa ilang pere, tapos ang baka ng bata, pag tapos ang bata, bullet it. That's right? Ang Q angle or quadriceps angle naman, that's the force of the, or the pull of the quadriceps. Kung tatawin yung video, ang pull sa quadriceps is towards the lateral side of the thigh. Towards the lateral side. Okay? Born by popping a straight line along the midline of the patella. Okay? And the medial tuberosity. And another towards the axis of the ASIS. Ang muna siyang angle. Normally, kung i-subtract mo sa 180, which is a straight line, ang tibiofemoral angle mo, makuha mo ang Q, which is 10, between 12 to 15. Okay? So, don't, ano siya? Supplement siya. Meaning, ang Q angle is supplementary to your tibiofemoral angle. Okay? So, next slide. Propedial, osa, we will take this up. Kamal, gusto ko lang magalaan niyo what are its contents, no? You have your popliteal vessels, your small saphenous vein, common perineal, epithelial nerves, your tendons of the thigh, radicular branch of the obturator nerve, connective tissue. These are the contents of your tissue. Ako lang din yung contents are your common perineal and your nerves, your saphenous, and then your blood vessels. Next slide. Each vessels. Lateral boundaries. Biceps femoris above. Is the lateral head of the gastric implantaris below. Next slide. Okay. So, lateral, biceps, and the implantaris and gastroc. So, alin mo nga popliteal vessels. Ano mga sciatic which branches into your perineal and your tibia. Slide. semi-member nostrils and semi-tendy nostrils above, medial head and the last of below. So, yan naman yung medial body. Next slide. Press. Okay? So, yung diamond shape niya, ako na siya yung medial body. Drag niya naman pag-baking yung mga medial artery passage. Next slide. So, floor is formed by the femur. The posterior ligament of the knee joint. The root is formed with skin, superficial, and deep fascia of the thigh. So kung tanawin nyo, ang inyong pagkakitsan po sa ang salugya, muni? Ang salugya, muni? Ang iyang atok, ang inyong panit, ang iyang dingding, ang inyong semi-mem, semi-ten, medial head of the gastrophilic, ang dingding, hindi naman niya sa piha, biceps, kanaglateral head naman sa sa classroom at yung natin. Next slide. So, ang hirap sa tayo, napakanan nyo, no? Pagkuha niya sa exam, makutunta ka kung ano ang branch siya o kung ano ang peron artery. Or, kung sa vein naman, ano ang iyang tributary, kung ano ang pag-ibig siya. Example. So, Janita, as you have your femoral, once it goes out of the adductor hiatus, then you have your superior medial and lateral genitulae, superior medial and lateral genitulae, and your sural branches there. As your medial goes down, it branches into two, your anterior medial and then your posterior medial. Okay? Next slide. Amo niya. Ayun mo yung sir ng ilya. Pag lusot niya sa inguinary ligament, it changes its name into femoral artery. Then it has branches now. Superficial circumference ilia, superficial epigastric, peroneal, superficial external ligament. Okay, next slide. Then you have your femoral artery, which will have a main branch for your punta femoris, of which you have the following branches. Your medial circumference femoral, lateral circumference femoral, your perforating branches, and then your descending branch. It highlights only descending branch, okay? A descending branch also gives blood supply to the knee. Okay? A popliteal artery naman yun. On the other hand, you have the following branches. Your medial and lateral genicular, of which you have two, superior and inferior, and your sural canal. So, yung iba kay yellow vein, amuli sila ang mga arteries na nakatagin sa medial supply sa ibang na tubod. Okay? Next slide. Venous drainage naman. You have your short saphenous, which enters into your popliteal artery, and then your greater saphenous, which enters into your femoral vein. Okay, so, tributaries na lang ato. No? Next slide. So, nagsilid kita na may arap ng concomitant veins to your arteries. Correct? The same name na siya. So, your greater saphenous, then your vena comitantes, the four veins that enter the femoral canal, mga epigastric na mga kapat, then the profunda femoris and its four tributaries. So, kumakutok pa ka mo, ano ang four tributaries sa profunda femoris? The same ang name niya sa branches sa profunda femoris artery. Medial and lateral circumflex, perforating, and the descending branch. Ano mo yan? Ano mo siya? Kaling na ilang kala. Okay? Then, sa popliteal vein naman, you have your lesser saphenous and the vena comitantes. So, makapagod pa kano. What are the tributaries or the deep veins that drain to the popliteal arteries from the knee? Ah, sa inyo, medial and lateral, genicular, both superior and inferior, and the sural. Plus, of course, the anterior and posterior tibia. Slide. Okay, the meniscus. So, if I ask you, ano difference sa medial and lateral meniscus? Sa shape. P and C shape. Ang medial, ang almost circular is the lateral. So, ang muli siya, oh, Kung tinawon nyo, if you look at this in a three-dimensional manner, ang femur mo ay sa babaw. No? So you have your... Mabangkot sa inyo. Ang two-shaped ligaments are named according to their attachment to where? The femur or the tibia? The tibia. So they like it. Ano ni siya ho? Tibial tuberosity. Ano niya kulo ano?
Tibial.
So di naman tibial. Ni o ni? A or B?
A.
So ano niya ang ligament?
Tibial.
Ah. Tibial. Tibial. Ini?
Tibial.
Okay, next slide. So, pop. So, before that. Okay, next slide. So, ang maraming difference nila. Ang shape, ang median is C. Ang lateral is circular. Size nila, kita nyo naman ito, mas longer, posteriorly. Mas smaller ang lateral. Movements, minay sa iyan na kwan na where it's situated. Ang median has less compared to the lateral. You have a median collateral, semi-membered attachment to your median collateral, semi-membered ossus and ACL. Ang posterior naman, meniscotemporal joint from wrist bird is attached to the lateral. Ang mga tinatawag nila na wrist bird ligament. Then, your obliqueus and your posterior cruciate. So, ang anterior cruciate is attached to the medial. Ang mga posterior cruciate is attached to the lateral. So, not infrequently, on this side, severe forms of injury. If you have cruciate injuries, you also have some form of avulsion involving the meniscus. Okay? Next slide. So, common attachments of the meniscus is your intercondylar tubercle, the tibial condy, and lago by the coronary ligament. Kasi the coronary ligament, ako siyang ligament na kapalibot sa yung mga meniscus. Then your patella by the meniscus patellar and patellotemporal ligaments. And of course, your transverse ligaments. So you're going to define the ligaments in this slide. So ayun, your anterior cruciate and your posterior cruciate. Your lateral collateral and your medial collateral. So kahapos na mag-assess ang knee, eh, kumabalaan ko kundiin ang area, kapag ano kung medial sa upper lateral. Okay? So kung kumakotot pa kami, ano ang dinarestrict sa cruciate knee? Dinarestrict yung extension o kung dinarestrict yung flexion? Okay, so the anterior cruciate is tightness. The opposite manner, the posterior cruciate naman is tightest to the flex. Next slide. So, lateral to lateral. Lateral condyle, at the insertion, attachment is the head of the fibula. Ang medial collateral naman, medial condyle, attached naman to the medial condyle of the fibula. So, ang iyang tension is increased. So, kung let's say we render covalgus stress sa tuhod, ano man ligament ang hugot? Medial or lateral condyle? Aryo? Let's say, ang pasyente niya, no? Tapos siling ko, abitan, ang ko ba, mabalgo, stress ko siling mo? Medial condyle is tightened during valgo stress. How about during valgo stress? Lateral condyle. So, may ara ko isang kapasyente the other day. Siling niya, ang ginimo ko, Doc, nag-di-quattro ko, tapos din-stretch ko lang tuhod ko, and then I felt something pop here on the side. And when I did baro stress, sakitan siya. So, anong ligament ang isofria? Medial or lateral collateral? Side. So, this is your part of your lateral collateral. Shape. Origin, again, from the tibia. Para hindi ka mo mag-pulay yan, amin mo na lang, may ho. P, L, A, and T. anak. Para di ka mo mula yan. Muna ako kami na isa. Kundi ang iyan ang origin. Ang iyan ang origin is what? Ang iyan ang origin is reason. Kapanulang tas ang iyan ang origin sa tibia, correct? Okay, next. Yes. Okay. Do you have any questions?